So, good evening.
Today here we are going to be with sheet number 6. Already we are with sheet number 5 where we have graphical method that is dead load and wind load. So now in this we are going to plot this. Now you can see how we have to go for this one. Maximum portion we are going to be keeping for your sectional elevation of truss, and then we have to show ridge joint, yield joint. And that is bottommost joint, and then cross section of top chord and bottom chord members. So likewise, you have to divide your sheet into two parts. So in one part we have only this sectional elevation, and here we have two joints and cross section of top chord and bottom chord member. Now how to plot it? You have to go in the same fashion. First you plot centroidal line of these truss. After centroidal line, then you can have this bottom chord member, then you have to draw this top chord member. Whatever I have seen, so in the same way you have to plot it. Do not change anything. Then I will go with purlins here. So I will show all the purlins on this one. So after showing purlins, then our next step, we have to put the roofing over here. And then after roofing, I have shown this. Then you have to draw the centroidal line, that is for the joints. And after plotting these all centroidal lines, you have to go for the members. Then I will plot members in this. When you can see these members, we are going to plot over here. And same way we have to plot on the other side also. Now you can see on left side, we have thickness on the right side, and on right side, we have thickness on left side to maintain CG, so that your distance of this CG will be at same distance from the centroidal, and therefore we have to plot in this fashion. So we can have this thickness that is on towards east side, towards each other. So these are all your members, and then you have to go for these gusset plates. Now while plotting gusset plate, you have to keep in mind this should be perpendicular to your member. So here also you can see this will be perpendicular to member, so that it becomes easy for go for the joint connection. So now likewise I have plotted a gusset plate at all joints, and you have to go in this fashion for this. Now we will go for the support. Then we have this will be support, and that angle section we have made over here to this thickness, and or I can say this outstanding member of this and outstanding member of this, we can connect over here. So now in the same way we can have on this side, and then we can have this gusset plate over here, and then on the other side. Now we have to actually show joint A, which we are going to say ridge, then U joint, we have joint B, and then we have to go for section 1-1, which is for top chord member, and section 2-2, which we have for the bottom chord member. So these joints we have plotted below, which we have to plot in second part. Now again we have to go in the same fashion. We have to first plot the centroid, then we have top chord member, then we will plot bottom chord member, and then we have this gusset plate. So you can see this is perpendicular to the member on the member, and then we have this will be your bolts. So 4 we have for top chord members, and 2 we have for that is for your other members, or we can say members which are other than top chord and bottom chord members. That already we have seen that in the design of these members. So this is your joint A, then we have that is ridge joint, then we have that is at support, we have U joint. And here you can see this, we have again in the same way we have first plotted centroidal lines, then we have top chord member, bottom chord member, then we have this purlin, then gusset plate, then we have four bolts for top chord, 4 bolts for bottom chord member, then this will be your roof, then we have this will be gutter joint. Gutter and its joint. So this is your joint B, and then we have top chord member section 1-1. We have seen that is top chord member in this way, and then we have section 2-2, which is bottom chord member, and for bottom chord member again we have double angle section. So likewise you have to plot your sheets, and in that sheet you have to make it two parts. First part we have sectional elevation, second part we have ridge joint, we have U joint, and then we have section that is top chord member and bottom chord member. Likewise, you have to complete this sheet number 6. We will see in next video, that is sheet number 7. So we will stop here only today. So thank you.